forget me. I promise to depart, just promise one thing. Kiss my eyes and lay me to sleep.
This is what I brought you, this you can keep. This is what I brought you, may forget me. I promise you my heart, just promise to sing. Kiss my eyes and lay me to sleep.
Hey guys, here we are in Germany, in Dortmund, intermodelbau, and we were flying 5 days with lovely couple from Germany, Mr. Martin Muller and Stephanie Schwan.
Hello!
So, here we have loads of Martin designs, and we will try to talk about first Shockflyers and how everything began. So, Martin, Stephanie, please tell the story of Shockflyer.
I trained a lot 3D flying on simulator with the extra of Roland Matt, and then I wanted to fly indoor with an extra, and I said to Martin, please build me an extra because I don't build planes, I'm only flying, and please build me an extra, the extra of Roland Matt for indoor flying.
This time I had a lot of different designs for indoor flying, and this time we tried different profile wings, big fuselage, things, stuff like this. Okay, I have everything, we had everything but no extras, so I said, shit, I need an extra. And it was the same time I had an idea for a new design. The improvement was always more to flat wing and flat body. And okay, at the end, the first prototype in this building shape, like a we call it Shockflyer right now, I built ever was an extra. It was definitely like that, an extra. So this plane, later you can buy it from Icarus, a company I was working for this time. Was almost the first Shockflyer I ever built. I make not much change for the kit. So I built this one and this was almost the first Shockflyer ever. Then we built two different types, Edge and Superstar also. But the Edge was the very first one.
So guys, the real story behind the woman was inspiring creation of Shockflyers, and it take. I remember when I saw these planes, it was like, wow! Yeah, and this technology develops right now so much, you can see many factories from Europe, America and so on. And we can see from many, many of your other designs, we can see your latest plane, also extra. What can you say about this? It's, if I'm right, it's about 10 years dividing this new model and this old model, yeah?
8 years.
8 years, okay.
Okay, the basic construction of Shockflyer is always the same, still the same. So
okay.
For me, what means is the Shockflyer is the body with two different shapes and this triangle to stiff the wing with the carbon flat rods on the back.
So it's basically the same construction.
It's basically the same.
Okay.
In the past. We make a lot of modifications for sure, and this plane is much better because it's actually my actual competition plane. But the basic idea and the construction is always still the same.
Okay. And I know there is something special European about this plane, so...
Yes, in this one, that's right.
Yeah, we see in the front your upside-down propeller.
Right.
You are designer of it, yes?
I designed this upside-down system for a company in Germany.
Mama Models, right?
Right, yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. And, okay, okay, the ups and downs is a VPP system, fine. But for the last World Air Games, I had the idea to make something new, to try the option to make new maneuvers.
Yeah,
and basically the idea is to have vector thrust control. So maybe 2 years ago I built this airplane with VPP system. Show you. With VPP system, you know it?
Yes.
But also with vector thrust control.
Okay, this is cool. Please move it. So it's connected to the rudder?
It's connected, and you need a strong servo, and then you can connect it with the rudder.
Okay.
So you always have the vector thrust combination with the rudder.
So I would say it is actual 4D, not just promotion.
Yes.
This is breaking the limits and creating new maneuvers.
And you have to learn flying from the beginning again because it's really different, especially if you fly vertically.
Okay, so once again, when was the date you designed it?
I think it's 2 years ago. 2 years ago, yeah.
2 years ago, okay.
Then this one, the crazy story is this one. This plane is really the first one I built ever because it was my practice plane for the World Air Games later. I built a new one for the competition, but this one I have here is, you can see it, it's the old one, it's the first one, it's 2 years old, but it still works fine, it's okay.
Yeah, you definitely cannot see these scratches and so on in a flight, you just see beautiful, technically difficult flight.
You can see I changed the battery off.
Could you tell a little bit about your setup, what you're running in it?
Yeah, sure, okay, for servos I use Hikit.
Yep.
This is 56.
Okay.
For rudders.
Yes.
Especially for rudder and ailerons, because ailerons are very big in this plane, and rudder needs thrust for the vector control.
Okay.
Okay. This one is a 35 megahertz old stuff receiver because it's 2 years ago. But right now I use also 2.4 multiplex system. The motor I use, the engine is not available anymore. It's a handmade motor from Switzerland.
Mm-hmm.
So okay, this is the special controller is CC10 from Castle Creation.
The best.
Works very well. It's definitely the best in this size.
Okay.
Yeah. Interesting thing is for the servo, in this VP system, you need really only a very small servo. This is a 3.2 gram servo. Very poor, cheap servo, but it's enough for this kind of control.
It's amazing for the middle shaft propellers I use. You basically need like metal gear at servo.
not with this system, because all the energy from the propeller goes not to the servo.
Okay, that is brilliant. That is German quality, let's say. Okay, so guys,
thank you for being here.
Thank you very much for interview. Lovely Stephanie.
Bye.
Okay.
You're welcome.